Hi, greetings, it's Akini. I'm back with a video, and this time I want to talk about the black persons, and I use the term black because that's what most people identify with. A few of you have like made little comments on my videos like, oh, black, we know black is a color. That don't mean, okay, I get it, okay? I'm trying to reach other people, so chill, thank you. But I wanted to address not only being a black person, but being a black woman in corporate America. I received a request from a sister that asked me to do a video about her experience. This sister, her name is Charmaine. Hello, how are you, Charmaine? Shout out to you. Thank you so much for emailing me. I really appreciate you reaching out to me. She does not live in the United States, but I mean, her experience reads very much like mine, so. You know, it's a global issue. So this sister works in a corporate environment. Other coworkers have been allowed. And when I say allowed, this is because the sister has escalated the issue. The sister has had to, she's had to endure racial jokes, racial epithets, inappropriate comments regarding race. To her, about her, her manager has only laughed about it because he or she thinks it's funny as well. So the sister has escalated it even further, and still these people are not being punished. If anything, for her, she's had to take days off and things like that, so she's lost money. They've just been very lackadaisical about the situation. They're not taking it seriously. This, you know, obviously when she goes into this job, there's a lot of tension, so I'm sure there's anxiety associated with this, because I know that was something that I dealt with. The first panic attack I've ever had in my entire life, I was 26, and it was at work because of my job. And I was at this job for 3 years. This sister says she's also been at her job for 3 years, and I think that's something about, 3 is my number anyway, like that's like my number, but something about that 3 where you're like, look, why am I here? This sister is educated, okay? She has several degrees, she has good work experience. I mean, it's the same thing. And you keep hearing these stories about black women are the most educated in the United States, demographic that's the most educated, and da 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 da. Right, we're striving, we're going to school and going to school and going to school, we're getting these jobs, we're getting these loans, we're doing this, we're pushing. Okay, we just saw Hidden Figures. You know, we'll be out here killing it. Okay, all of this stuff. And then we get to these jobs. First of all, I'm trying not to use any profanity. These people don't even pay you a quarter, half of what they're paying men in general. That means men of all races. But compared to white men, you're getting nothing. And you can have more education. Okay, you can have, you know, I've seen people with bachelor's degrees manage people with master's degrees or multiple master's degrees. And I'm not saying because somebody has a bachelor's degree that they weren't fit for that job, but I'm just telling you that you getting these degrees, it doesn't always mean that you're gonna go be the director of something and run stuff. It doesn't work like that, especially when you're a black woman. The promotions come very little. Especially if you do not shuck and jive. You have, the only way to survive is to shuck and jive. Okay, that's the, that is my motto for corporate America. Okay, I even got written up, not written up, I got addressed about not being social and not being engaged. I was like, that's not a part of my job. Like, are you serious right now? Like, I wanted to just, I wanted to go off. Like, and then it's like when you go off, of course, my sisters know you're the angry black woman. So a lot of us hold back. Let me tell y'all something that I did. I stopped holding back. Okay, I did. Because I was like, you know what? Who's going to check me, boo? Who's going to check me? Like, what are you going to do? You're going to kick me out of here? And I can go to the EEOC and clown? Y'all gonna kick me out of here so I can go home and work at my home business? What's up? let's go. That's how I felt, because I was so fed up with the job. This lady, I mean, I feel really bad for her. I mean, because I know what it's like, and you feel stuck. You feel really stuck, like, I can't get out of this place because I have to pay my bills. Like, I have to feed my kids. I have to do whatever you do with your money you make, right? And our generation, and I was born in 88, but my generation, a lot of us have figured out you have to have a side hustle. There are some people that are just now catching up to that. But you're seeing, like, if you don't have something outside of one of these jobs, like, you're fucked. It's gonna keep it 1,000. A lot of people are realizing that. And, I mean, it's really easy to do. It's really not that complicated. People have been doing it forever, but it's just, it's coming to a point where it's like, if you don't have something, even if it's something on the back burner that you're not even doing right now, if you don't have an alternate route, like, it's not cool. Especially when you're in a predicament where you go to work, you work the same 4 hours a week, you got the same family and bills that these other people have, and you get paid, like, significantly less. People don't want to promote you. I was having issues. Not only was I being treated unfairly by my supervisor, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to apply out. And I'm going to get from up under this person, get a new supervisor, you know what I'm saying? I'll have time to get a new game plan. Because I already knew, like, I can't stay at this job. Like, laughable. Like, I can't stay here. But I got to get away from this person that keeps bothering me, that keeps harassing me, right? I mean, this dude would just stand behind my desk, right? Like, he would just stand here. And I would be sitting there, like, and he would stand over me, almost like, honestly, like on some plantation shit. Like, okay, keep working. I'm watching you. It was so uncomfortable, y'all. Like, it was so uncomfortable. Like, I can't even. Oh, give me the heebie-jeebies thinking about, like, the creepiness of it all. But anyway, so what ended up happening is. I ended up having to go to HR. Now let's talk about the coons. The sister in her email, first she said, man, all of these black people at my job just want to assimilate with the white people. Like, they're so, like, you know, they just let stuff slide because they just want to fit in so bad. Okay, those are coons. Okay. Those are people that, I mean, when you're oppressed, you're going to do one of two things. You're either going to try to comply so that it doesn't, you know, affect you, or you don't think it's going to affect you in a particular way, or you're going to resist because you're like, man, this ain't cool. Okay, well, coons are people that are just like, man, let me just comply. Okay, I just need to make this money, and I'm not going to, you know, this is just how it is. I'm going to accept this for what it is. I don't, you know, y'all need to come on over here too, which I need to do. And just do whatever they say, okay? And just lay low. You know, it's cool. That's how coons think. They think it's the easier route because you're not opposing. That's not the truth. I saw Stacey Dash just lost her job, so after all that cooning. And that's usually what happens too. It's pretty sad. But anyway, so the people, you know, they don't want to. It's like they don't even want to acknowledge what she's going through. They don't want to get involved or anything. And she's like, y'all see this though. When I said I was going to HR about my supervisor, every single black person that I talked to at my job was like, don't do that. You don't want to rock the boat. Just chill. Whatever. Da-da-da. None of them wanted me to say anything. Everybody wanted me to remain non-confrontational. Now, mind you, this man is still just standing behind my desk. Like, I'm uncomfortable as hell. Like it makes me uncomfortable. Like I said, he was the cause of my very first panic attack. Like, imagine driving to that place every day. See, people don't think about all the aspects of dealing with this kind of stuff at your job. You're basically being bullied. Okay? And that's why when I did go to HR, I told them that I was being bullied. So then I felt bullied. Like, I told them, like, I wasn't. See, a lot of us, we want to act. So let me do a little aside. A lot of us want to, when we do address stuff, we want to act hard. I didn't want to seem soft. I didn't want to seem this. No, tell them, especially y'all sisters. No, tell them, like, this hurts. This makes me uncomfortable. I'm having panic attacks. A lot of us like to laugh at our white counterparts because they're so, you know, they can be so called over dramatic and things like that. But they get shit done, don't they? No, stop trying to act hard. That's that slave stuff. Y'all be trying to buck up so hard. No, I'm having panic attacks. If you feel like bursting into fucking tears, do it. Okay? I was pregnant at the time. So that added to my benefit. I was just like, look, the stress, the baby, I can't do it. And I was being for real, though. Like, I'm not lying, y'all. I'm not telling y'all to go in there and lie. But be for real. Like, stop with the trying to act hard and stuff. Tell them the real deal. What's really going on with you? Especially if you are having anxiety attacks, you are going to the doctor. I have my notes in my hand from my doctor. So I wasn't playing no games. When I felt like they were not moving fast enough, I told them I was going to get the law involved or the EEOC involved. I was not playing with these people. Y'all got to stop being scared to speak up and to do something else about it. Like, seriously, like, it's like we don't even want to say anything. But anyway, these coons, everybody told me not to say nothing. Okay. I did. I spoke up. I followed up. Okay. Okay, I got with my ancestors. Okay. And this person was removed from being my supervisor. My next supervisor, she was a hot mess too. She was a hot mess too. She wasn't as bad as him, but she was a hot mess too. But she didn't choose me to pick on. She chose another black woman to pick on. She bothered me sometimes, but she didn't choose me to pick on. They usually have one person that they bother a lot. But it's a very stressful thing to be an African-American woman, black woman, woman of color. Especially as a black woman, because, like, you know, I saw a meme recently that was just like, you know, I'm not marching for no march when y'all don't even have to worry about how to wear your hair for an interview in order to get a job. And I was like, like, okay, that's some real talk. We have specific issues, and that's why we need to address those specific issues instead of including everybody all the time. It's another problem that we have. Many who's That's how black people are at the jobs. You have to assimilate, or, I mean, you're not going to be able to get through it. And that's basically, it's a coping mechanism. That's what a coon is doing. They're just trying to cope. They're uncomfortable, trust, but they're just trying to cope. You know, they let that friend make that racist joke, and they laugh along. Because they're just coping. That's how they deal with it. You just don't want to deal with it. And that's you. You're a different person. You have a different personality. I have the same type of viewpoint on that. I just didn't want to deal with it no more. I refused to not go to HR because at least I wanted to be able to say, well, I tried that and they didn't do nothing. Well, my company actually ended up doing something. And that was a positive experience for me. You know, because they did. They investigated. They investigated and he admitted, yeah, I stand and I watch her. I got to make sure she's on task, is what he told her. And I was able to prove via documentation that not only was I doing my job, I was doing better than a lot of other people who were actually slipping on their job. So it was like, yo, you spending all this time focusing on her and you have other people that are slacking. And then there were some other things that he was slacking on from a high level. So it was like, look, we're just going to have to let you, you can't be in this role anymore. Because I kind of basically shone a light on the fact that he wasn't doing the things he was supposed to be doing. So, you see what I'm saying? You see how stuff could work? But a lot of us hold stuff in. We don't want to say nothing. A lot of us feel like we can't leave certain places out of fear because of financial reasons. And like I said, this is why it's so important for y'all to start these side hustles, man. To write these books, man. To do all this other stuff. There's so many things y'all could be doing. The internet makes it so easy to make money. I'm not even going to sit up here and lie. Like, the internet makes it so easy to make money. Especially y'all who are always on the internet. Like, just post, like, my son's old clothes. I'm giving these away for $10. Like, somebody will buy it from you. Like, you know what I'm saying? Get it in. But yeah, so basically my advice to that sister is be looking for a new job. Definitely be looking for a new job. Go to your human resources department. Going to that person's boss doesn't always work, because a lot of times these people are friends, man. That's how they do it. They only fuck with each other. And everyone keeps talking about how black women are starting all these businesses. This is why. Because we're tired. We're tired of going to work and being treated like crap and working like a mule to make half of what everybody else is making. Like, our families don't eat food too. So, I mean, it just, honestly, you know, I believe that there are a lot of spiritual components to this. It's absolutely the return of the Divine Mother. We're recognizing our power as women, as consumers, and we're doing, there's a lot of things that are going on a spiritual level. And women are realizing that a lot of our power is at home, especially for those of us who have children. And so there's just a lot of things that are just going on an energetic and a spiritual level with, you know, women leaving, black women leaving the workplace and or starting businesses at such an alarming rate. So this is interesting. This is something that I'm watching. But my advice to her is to definitely escalate the issue to human resources. If they don't do anything, there are other departments that you can go to, but also be looking for another job / and starting another side hustle, starting your side business. Even if it's putting money away for your business, do something to start that process. Something like, it really doesn't even make sense not to have a domain name and a website. Like, I mean, if you're going to be selling online or you need something, a visual, it really doesn't make any sense not to have some brochures or some cards even. Like, cards are not that expensive to get. So that's just a really, really big issue. And I understand the microaggressions, the little comments, people asking you about your hair, people making little racial jokes. One thing I hate so much is when they try to use slang. It's like, why are you doing that to me? Why? Because you want me to slap the piss out of you, don't you? But you know, if I do that, I'm going to get in trouble. You have to ask yourself, what kind of person would provoke you like that? You got to ask yourself, what kind of person would hire you and pay you so much less than someone else? Like I said, like, your family don't have to eat. You got to ask yourself, that's some evil shit. And that's why I just was like, you know what? I can't do it. I just can't do it. I just cannot do it. Like, it's so stressful. Like, and I told myself, I was like, if I have to go back, it's like 3 to 6 months and I'm out of that bitch. Like, I can't do that every single day. I can't. I can't sit there and play nice with people who talk crazy to me all the time, and then management won't do anything about it. So I basically come here to get abused every day just so I can make money. I stand on the shoulders of women who had to do that because they had to drop out of school in third grade to help their mom work so they could make money to live. I stand on those women's shoulders and I thank the universe for them. But I don't have to do that. And I'm so thankful. And so I'm not going to do it just because I get to sit at a desk and I have on like cute clothes and I get to listen to some music. I'm not going to do it. Especially now that I have lives that I'm molding as a mother. Like I said, especially not for no long term. I absolutely cannot do it. It's just so important for women to get back to their creative endeavors and their spiritual endeavors that they want to do. Their passions. That's what's really going to change things. When women start doing what they are called to do, everything's getting shut down. Everything's going matrilineal in this mug, okay? But yeah, that's what I wanted to tell that sister. And, you know, sis, create an exit plan and just get out of there. Do not create an exit plan, create an exit plan, create an exit plan. Please have an exit plan. That's the only way you're going to keep sane. And there's no reason to stay anyway. So that's my advice for that. So I will catch y'all on the flip. Thanks.